great day to be in church. So, Father, we love you, and we thank you for this new opportunity to be in your house. God, we thank you always for new opportunities to worship you as a church family. God, I pray that this worship would bless you, and that through it you would prepare us for what you've given Pastor Palmer to bring this morning. Father, we love you, and we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
I've got a firm foundation. I'll rock the only solid ground. Nations rise and fall. Kingdoms once strong, now shaken. We trust forever in your name. Name of Jesus. We trust the name of Jesus. You are the only King forever. Almighty God, we lift you higher. We lift our
Church, and especially if you haven't been with us before, we'd like to especially welcome you. So if this is your first time with us, could you raise your hand? We just want to clap for you and give you a little packet of info. Welcome. Glad to have you. As far as announcements go, Tuesday. Sons of Promise is on Tuesday. This Sons of Promise meeting this time is going to be in the box front yard at 6:30. Bring your own lawn chair out there. If you don't know where the box live, it's the house right before the Newark Bridge with a little barn that looks just like a deer at night in your headlights when you come up the hill. So it's right there. But we're going to worship out there in fellowship. And so that is if you're involved with Sons of Promise. So 6:30 at the box residence. We want to continue to keep Dave and Floyd and those guys in our prayers while they're in Moldova. Haven't heard an update on that, so I'm assuming it's going okay, though. But other than that, one more thing, the swing set fundraiser. We're still about $980 short on that for the fundraiser for the kids. And something I was confused about, so I'm going to say it in case anybody else is like me and dense somewhat. The new swing set that's out there is not the one that we're fundraising for, I think. If it is, I'm going to tell you who said it later, that it's not. But it is a totally separate thing, I think. So we're trying to get the Samuel Center playground or swing set there. So if we can, they're going to be having a, oh my goodness, I forgot what it was. What's the fundraiser? Ice cream, yes. Ice cream social. And you're going to have to look in your bulletin because I didn't write it on my cheat sheet, obviously. So, if Judy could pray over the offering, we're going to take the offering and continue to worship.
Heavenly Father, we just thank you for a beautiful morning, Lord. God, we thank you for the seats we're sitting in and the sanctuary that we have to worship you in, God. And we thank you mostly that you're here with us. You've come to meet with us. So this morning, Lord God, as we worship and fellowship with you, God, I ask this morning, Father, that you would receive our next gift of our tithes and our offerings to you, that we would lay them at your feet, God, that we would envision as we're placing it in the offering plate, Lord God, that really is a gift back to you and a thank you to you, God, for how you provide for us. So God, this morning, Lord God, as we continue to worship you and tell you how much we love you and spend time with you, God, would you just touch our hearts today, Lord God. There are hearts here that are hurting and broken. There are hearts here that are full of you, Lord God, of great things you've done. And Lord, we just ask, Lord, that you would be with us. Use this tithe and this offering, Lord, to touch lives, to promote your kingdom, to expand what you're doing. And God, we give you all of the glory and honor and all of the praises that go with it right back to you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you. Paid for me, what you
declare your praise for the glory of your name.
Sometimes, and I don't feel like I know, Now you can preach the word and preach the word and preach the word, and we're going to probably do that this morning. But sometimes you just have to do the word. And we want to be both speakers and hearers and doers. And this morning, I feel like it's very important to pray for some people here and to obey the scriptures. The word of God in the book of James says this in verse 5. It says, if anyone is among you is suffering, let him pray. If anyone is cheerful, let him sing praise. If anyone among you is sick, let him call for the elders of the church and let him pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith will save the one who is sick, and the Lord will raise him up. And if he has committed sin, he will be forgiven. Therefore, confess your sins one to another and pray for one another that you may be healed. The prayer of a righteous person has great power as it is working. You know, our prayers don't save or heal anyone. God does. But God tells us in his word that we come to him in prayer and ask for healing. Laying hands on people doesn't heal anyone, but his word says and tells us to do that, and so we do that. Anointing people with oil, it isn't the oil that heals, it's God's power, and it's the symbolization of the Holy Spirit who really does come and heal that that's all about, what's going on. And this morning, you know, this week, I've been angry at the devil. I had several times this week to pray for ladies in this church who are sick. And not just a little bit sick, but a lot sick. And that has got to change. To have a church this size and to have one person deathly ill is a bad thing. To have multiple people in that space is not right. And so the word of God says, you come, and we lay hands on, and we pray. And I'll tell you this morning, as I've been standing up in here, I've been trying to reach down to the bottom of my boots, and I don't know how to pray in faith. I don't even sometimes think I have a whole lot of faith, but I do know what the Word of God says. And we're going to do that today. And we're going to start with Audrey. Audrey's here this morning. And if you bring, David, if you bring Audrey up, gentlemen, I've asked some of the guys that speak if you just come and gather around. Come on up. We're going to pray for people. And I, you know, sometimes in the midst of this, you'd line a bunch of people up and pray for a bunch of people. But this morning, I feel like it's important that we take all of our faith, whatever measure of it is, however mustard seed small it might be, and we put it all together and we start praying for some people. And Cheryl, we're going to pray for you. And Jan, we're going to pray for you. And there's going to be, I think we just need to, one at a time, bring people through and pray for them, if that's okay. If you want to stand, if whatever you need to do to join in, because this isn't about my faith, it's not about these guys' faith, it's about God. But God has told us that as the church of God, that if we'll gather around those that are sick, that there'll be a work. And we're going to pray that this morning. So God, men, lay your hands on her, God. Father God, we come in the name of Jesus this morning and in the power of the Holy Spirit, and we lift Audrey up to you. God, we pray for her body. Lord, as frail as it may be, Lord, we pray that you would come and give her strength. You would come and impart power upon her. God, you would impart your vision and understanding and the knowledge of your work in her life. And Lord God, for the diseases that are going on in her body, we come against them in the name of Jesus. For the sores that will not heal, we come against those things in Jesus' name. And this morning, oh God, we speak to you, God, knowing that our faith is small, but you're a big God. That our words are few, but you're a powerful God. And Lord, this morning we trust you
We trust your word. We trust what you said. And Lord, we pray for Audrey this morning in faith, and we pray, God, that you would do a work of healing in her body, that you would do a work of restoration of life into her soul, into her mind, into the fullness of who she is. And so, God, we pray today in Jesus' name for healing to take place in this body, from her feet to her head, all the way through. Every place where there's been bacteria, where there's been poison that is just trying to destroy her body, we pray, God, for life. We speak life into this body. We speak life in the name of Jesus. For her to be healed, O Lord, in your name, by your power. In Jesus' name we pray this. Amen. Amen. Cheryl, if you want to come up. Thank you. We pray for Cheryl. We lift her up to you. We lift up again this other, another woman of God in this house. And Lord, we pray, oh God, for this. We pray for this liver, God. We pray for the disease that wants to afflict her body, God. Pray for any bit of cancer that wants to come into this situation, Lord God. Every bit of sickness, Lord God, we lift it up to you, oh God. We come against that in Jesus' name. And today, God, we pray for healing to come and take place in this body, in this life, in this heart, in this soul. Lord, we speak to this liver to be healed in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray, God, for wisdom for doctors. And if there's a need to replace this liver with another liver, that's up to you, God. But today, if you would do it today, by the power of your Spirit, you would do it today, oh God. We come before you. We ask, oh God. We petition. We do the only thing we know to do, which is to come before you and lay this woman. Come before you and lift up this woman. Come before you and lay hands upon this woman. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. And again, Lord, we speak healing. We speak life. We speak strength. We speak your power and your anointing to come and to touch her from her head to her feet, all the way through her body. Specifically, we speak into this liver, Lord God, to have life, to be right, to be whole, to work right. Come, Lord Jesus. Come, oh God. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, bring your anointing, your healing anointing. Let a healing anointing work in this house and today. Let a healing anointing work in this life and in this body today. And God, we come in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. And God, forgive us for lack of faith. We trust you, God. We trust you, oh God. Come, Lord God. Have your way. Have your way, God. Heal this body. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord God. Jan Fredrickson, would you come up? Again and again. And Lord, we thank you for the work that you've already done, the healing that's taken place in this life. But God, we ask for more. We ask for the full measure of healing to come and work in this life, God. In her system, Lord, in this leukemia, that it would be completely red and gone. And no more. And Lord, all the effects of all the things, whether it's on her white blood count and her heart rate, all of those things, God, today we speak life. We speak wholeness. We speak wellness in the name of Jesus. Touch Jan today. Speak to her. Work in her, Holy Spirit. Come and move upon this body all the way through and through and through and through. God, we come in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. That this body would be healed in your name, by your power, for your glory's sake, oh God. Not because of what we do, but because of who you are. Because of who you are today. Show yourself as strong. Show yourself as who you are. We believe, God, your arm is not short. Your power is not weak. And you're a God who creates. And you're a God who sustains. And you're a God who heals. We trust that this morning in Jesus' name. Touch this body. Touch this body in Jesus' name. Be healed. In the name of Jesus. Be healed. Be healed in Jesus' name. Come, Lord Jesus. Denzel, could you come up here? God is not a respecter of time or place. And Denzel's wife, Susan, had to be home most of the time lately. And we're just going to pray for Denzel on Susan's behalf. Lord God, we know that you're a God who's everywhere all the time. But God, we don't know anything other to do than to lift up our voice together as a body, lift up our voice together as the church, and God, to pray for Susan. Even though she's not here, God, we know that you can do a work, and we're praying for Denzel as a representative of her, God, and we pray, God, for her, God, to be healed and to be whole, for her kidneys to work right, God, for every part of her system that's off and not working this morning, God, that you would come in your power and your strength, and you would bring healing to this body. Heal Susan Dunn, Lord, by your power and by your strength. Come, Lord Jesus, by the work that you've done, oh God. Have your way in this life. Have your way in this body. Bring life. We speak life into this body. We speak wholeness and wellness into this body. Come, Lord Jesus. Have your way. In Jesus' name we pray. Come, Lord God. Let her be healed. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Gina, come up here, please. God, we come. Lord God, we come. We come, Lord God. Lord God. Lord, we touch Gina today. We lay hands upon her like your word says, God. And Lord, we thank you that you've done a work in the cancer in her body, but Lord God, the things that have been happened as a result of that treatment, and even all the way completely, we pray, God, that this cancer would be completely gone, not just in remission, but completely gone in the name of Jesus. And everything that wants to come, her emotions and her hormone, everything that wants to be affected by the medicine and all the things that have the chemotherapy and all the things, God, we come, we speak life, we speak wholeness, we speak wellness into this body. Touch her in Jesus' name. Lord, come and bring wholeness and health, well-being. Lord, in her mind, in her body, in her spirit, God, come and touch her, move upon her in Jesus' name. Have your way today. Heal her, God. Heal her in the name of Jesus. Heal her in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Come, Lord Jesus. Touch her, God. Touch her, God. Move upon her, Lord. Come, Lord God. Have your way, God. Have your way, God. Have your way, God. Touch her, God. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Come, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. You know, I just feel like there's several, I can't get to everyone by name, but I know there's several people here that need healing. There's several, particularly several ladies here. And if you all would just come, if you're sick in your body, yes, yeah, come on, you're who I'm looking at. Come on up. Come on. Whatever you are, Jan, come on, whoever, if you're suffering from anything today, that's doing a work on your body, we're just going to lay hands on Martha. Come up here. Come, Lord Jesus. Come, Lord Jesus. Lord God, Lord God. Come, Lord God. Come, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's just go down the line, ladies and men. Much touch. I want to pray for you. Come, Lord God. Lord, we come against the arthritis in this body. And Lord, we speak strength, healing, God, in her back. God, the work that the enemy wants to do to rob, steal, and destroy. Lord, we come in Jesus' name and we pray for health. We pray for well-being. Touch this body in the name of Jesus. Touch her, Lord God. Heal her, God. Heal her, God. Heal her, Lord Jesus. Touch this body, God. Heal her, God. Touch her, God. Or whatever's going on in this body, God, we come against it in Jesus' name, Lord. We pray for health. We pray for well-being, Lord God. Touch her, God. Be healed. Let her be healed in Jesus' name, in the name of Jesus. Come, Lord God. We come. We go down in the depths of who you are, oh God. We draw from the well of the Word, the well of your power, the well of the Holy Spirit, and we pray healing. We know that you can do it. It's not our prayers, it's your work, but God, you've asked us to come, and we ask for miracle power to work in this body and in these bodies, God. Come, Lord, bring healing. Touch her, Lord God. Touch this body to be healed and to be whole, to be well. Let healing come into this body, Lord God. Be healed, be well, be whole. Touch her, God. Touch her, God. Where everybody has sickness, everything that we want to come against her, Lord God, we pray in Jesus' name that you touch her, that you restore her, God. Come touch her, Lord God. Move upon Debbie, Lord God. In her body, heal her, God. Touch her, God. Have your way in this body, Lord God. Come, Lord Jesus. Move upon her, Lord God. Strengthen her, empower her, God. Holy Spirit, come. Let the creative power be at work in this body to do everything you've desired and you've designed, God. Every bit of life that you want, every moment that you've destined and purposed for this life, to fulfill your plan, to fulfill your purpose, Lord, we pray for physical strength to accomplish that. Touch her, God. Touch her, God. Move upon her in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. We pray for Jenny, Lord God. We pray for this back, Lord God. Lord God, there's... God, we thank you for doctors. We thank you for medicine. But God, there are times when we just need you to come. We need you to come and do what only you can do, God. And Lord, we pray for healing, a deep healing to take place in this back, Lord God. And this, everything that's wrong, everything that's not right would be come into alignment and be right and be whole. That this disc would be right. It would shrink. There would any impact it would have on the nervous system would be not and be gone in the name of Jesus. Healing, be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. Touch this body, Lord God. Come, Lord, to be right. Let her blood be right, Lord. Let her hemoglobin level be right in Jesus' name, oh God. And the root cause of this, God, we pray, God, that you would come and you would do a deep work. You would come on the inside, oh God, and come and heal completely and fully and wholly. Have your way, God. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Be healed in Jesus' name. Be healed in Jesus' name. Touch her, Lord God. Touch her, God. Touch her, God. Touch her, God. Come, Lord Jesus. Touch this body, Lord God. Come, Lord Jesus. We come. We come. Every life, this life, God. Touch Phyllis, God. Touch her, God. Touch her, God. Move upon her, God. Every bit of it, God. We speak life, wholeness, and wellness in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Come, Lord Jesus. Come, Lord God. Have your way, God. Draw her unto you, God. Move upon her, God, in strength and in healing, God. Lord, we touch Molly, God. We touch her, God. We speak to the disease that wants to rack her body, God. That it would be not, that it would have no impact, that it would be gone in Jesus' name. in Jesus' name. Do a deep work in her body. Give strength and power. God, I pray for her mind, her body, her soul, every little part of her being, Lord God, all of her cells, Lord God, that you would do a mighty work inside of her. Have your way in this life, Lord God. Bring healing to this body in the name of Jesus. Touch her, Lord God. Move upon her in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Fully and completely. Every spirit of infirmity be gone in Jesus' name. Be gone in the name of Jesus. Things of old, you have no power. You have no power in this life. This is a new day. And we're going to speak healing for a new day. A new day, the fullness of healing, the fullness of nothing needs to happen in Jesus' name. Power and strength and wholeness and wellness, be healed in the name of Jesus. Come, Lord Jesus. Come, Lord Jesus. Lord, all the way, fully and completely. Lord God, we thank you for the healing that you brought already to this body. But Lord God, we're praying for the full measure, the fullness of what you want, the fullness of what you desire, the fullness of what is needed to happen in this life, God. Every bit of it, God, we pray against every spirit of infirmity that would come into this life, Lord God. We pray for strength. We pray for power. Lord God, we pray for health and well-being and life. Come, Lord Jesus. Come, Holy Spirit, move in this life by your anointing power. Heal her in Jesus' name. Heal her in Jesus' name. Come, Lord Jesus. Touch this body, God. Touch this body, Lord. Come, Lord God. Do a deep work, God. Have your way, God. Every bit of sickness, every bit of everything that would come against her, Lord God, everything that's happened, everything that's going on in this life, God, we pray for redemption, the redemption of the Lord. Not just the healing of a physical body, but the redemption of the Lord to happen all the way through and through and through and through. God, make yourself known. Make yourself strong. Let it be seen. Let your strength be seen, oh God, in this life. Heal her mind, body, and soul. Strengthen her life. Strengthen her, God. Show her to who you are, God. Do such a miraculous miracle that there can be no denying it's you and your power, God. Have your way, God. Touch her, God. Touch her, God. I touch Susan, God. Touch her, God, deep within her body, God. Lord, all the things that have come against her, again, any spirit of infirmity, God, we come against it in Jesus' name. Lord, we speak for health and well-being. We speak for her mind and her heart and her soul, for every bit of her being, God, for you to come and you to work your full power in this life, your full healing to take place in this life, God. Come, Lord God, have your way. Have your way, God. Do your work. Let your name be known. Let your name be declared. We declare the name of Jesus over this life for health and well-being, for wholeness all the way through in Jesus' name. Touch her, God, in Jesus' name. Touch her, Jesus. Touch her. Come, Lord God. Have your way, God. Come, Lord God. We speak healing into this life. Healing in Jesus' name. Touch your body, God. Touch your God fully and completely in Jesus' name, for your presence, for your power, for your strength, for your anointing, for your healing. For your healing, God. For your healing, God. Come, Lord Jesus. Everything that would come against this young girl, God, we speak against it. And we speak life, and we speak wholeness, and we speak wellness in the name of Jesus. Lord, rise up. Rise up in this life, oh God. Come and anoint her with your healing power in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Touch her. Come, Lord God. Touch Kathy, God. Come, Lord God. Move in this life. Move in this body. Every bit, oh God. Every bit whole, God. Every bit whole, God. Come and Lord. Come even upon her legacy, God. We just don't pray for Kathy, Lord. We pray for her legacy, God. And there would be no her physical legacy and her spiritual legacy. God, we come in Jesus' name for Kathy and every woman she represents. And we pray healing all the way down, Lord God. Every bit of cancer, every bit of any disease that would rack this body or any of these bodies, God, we pray in Jesus' name that you'd come and you'd touch. You'd come and you'd make whole. You'd come and you'd make well, God. Lord, we've seen great miracles in this family. But God, we come again for your power and your anointing to do a complete and powerful work, God. A full work in the name of Jesus. Come, Lord God, have your way, God, have your way. Be seen and known for who you are, the God of the universe, the creator of all, the healer, the redeemer, the restorer. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Touch your God, touch your God. God, touch Amber's body, God. Touch this body in Jesus' name. All the way, God. All the way through and through, God. Have your way, God. Come bring strength and power, God. Do a work in her body, God. Lord, we rebuke any sickness, we rebuke any illness, any disease. We come against you in Jesus' name. We pray for restoration and wholeness and health and well-being. Lord God, we trust you for who you are. We believe you, God. We believe you today, God. Even our unbelief, God, we pray, God, we believe you, we trust you, have your way, God, touch her, God, move upon her in Jesus' name, God, come, Lord Jesus, come, Lord God, have your way, God, have your way, God, have your way, God. Dana Burrows is not here today. I was with her Friday night in the hospital. And every single time I walk in that room, there's just joy and faith and peace. She had 3 blankets on and she was cold and she couldn't get warm. But her spirit was well. And so we're going to pray for Dana. God, we just come today, Lord, again. We know it's not just about being here. It's not just about our hands. It's about your power. It's about your strength. And God, even in the impossible, even when doctors have said something completely different, God, we come today and we ask, oh God, in your name for life. We ask, oh God, in your name for strength. We ask in your name for power to just pour into that body, God. Lord, we come against this pancreatic cancer and its work of just destroying this body. We come against it in Jesus' name, oh God, and we pray for power. We pray for strength. We pray for healing. We pray for anointing. We pray for life. 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 In Dana Burrows' body, God. Touch her, God. Heal her, God, in Jesus' name. We trust you that she will be healed. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
If there is anybody here who has his sickness in his body, let him put his hand.
You know, if we've been praying for most of, you know, it's right to just pray for everybody that needs healing. Here's how we're going to do that. If you need healing in your body, put your hand on wherever you need healing, and I'm going to pray, and we're going to pray, and let God have his way and his work. Whoever it might be, wherever it might be in the midst of it. Man, woman, child, whoever it is, God, we come today, right now, in the name of Jesus. And Lord God, we come against the enemy that's trying to pour out a spirit of infirmity in this house. We come against that. We stand on your name. We stand in your power. We stand in your strength. And we shut every door, every way that the enemy would want to come in and wreak havoc in this place in our physical bodies. And Lord, today, in the name of Jesus, for everybody in this room that needs a touch by your spirit, that needs a touch by your power, that needs a touch by your anointing, God, we pray today, God, that you would touch them, you would move upon them, not just a little bit, but a lot, not just sort of, kind of, but whole, God, we pray for healing, the healing power of Jesus, the healing power of the Holy Spirit to work all the way across. across this room, oh God, from this side of the room all the way through and through and through and through and through, God. Not because of what we can do, but because of what you can do. Not because we wanted, but because you desired, you said it, and we believe your word for what it is. Have your way in this house, God. God, do a work in this place, oh God. Let us be healed, God, in our hearts, in our minds, in our bodies, in our souls. God, do a work in us, God. Have your way, Lord God. Heal us in Jesus' name. Heal us in Jesus' name. Yeah, what do you think? Yeah. We have a mic.
I feel like God wants to give us a supernatural power in prayer for healing. And that means if you're in your office and your coworker needs healing, you can pray for them. And his power is going to come and things are going to change. That means when you're at home in your own prayer closet and you know of needs, you're going to pray and the power of God is going to come and it's going to change things. And God wants to give us a deposit this morning. And so if you feel like that's something you want to function in your life, there's no age limit on this, okay? If you want that, this church is being called to something today. We've tasted this lots of different times, but tasting isn't good enough. We're in a fight. I read something actually just yesterday that said, you're in spiritual warfare whether you want to be or not. If you're a Christian, you've signed up. You are in spiritual warfare. And God wants to come and give us a deposit to bust through some things that we've just hit against. So if that is you, if you're saying, I want that, I want to do it, I'm going to invite you to come up here and we're going to pray. And a deposit of God is going to begin to come and fill us. You can go ahead and come if that is you. I want a supernatural deposit of prayer for healing.
While you're coming up, listen to this.
While this has all been going on, I just know that I had been through this fight, and there's a lot of things that God is trying to teach us. As Martha's just saying, we're in a battle, but it's not that we're going to be defeated. It's just that we have a lot of things to learn, and the reason we come against all these things is because we need to learn how to fight, and we're not learning how to fight. We're not listening to the Lord, and we're not waiting on Him, and we're not asking Him, how do we fight this battle? When we come into the presence of God, we need to say, Lord, what do you want me to do? How do you want me to do it, and what do you want me to say? And the thing that the Lord, I know verses to do with healing, but the one that the Lord, I believe, gave me was the one in Psalm 103, which says, God heals all my diseases. Now, if it's the word of God, He never lies. It is true. And you may not believe it, you may not feel it in your body, but you can declare it into the heavenly realm. You can declare it into the air around you, over you, to the powers of darkness, that God heals all of our diseases. And you may not feel it, and you might, you know, I had to, they say walk it out, but you're going to say, oh, I think I'm feeling sick coming on, I think this is, but no, because you just have to say, no, God heals all my diseases. It's not me, it's God. God heals all of our diseases. That's what His word says. And He doesn't lie, because He's not a human being, He's God. And you need to keep saying it, and it took me years to get what I'm wanting, and there's a little bit more to come, but in the process I was told is good, because it makes you call out to God. It makes you depend on God. And that's what He wants you to do. If you can walk, because He wants you to walk so close to Him that when you come up against, like what Martha was saying, when you come up against a friend who's sick, you can say, no, we're not having that. In the name of Jesus, no, God heals all our diseases. And that's what we need to be doing.
All right, here's how I believe we're going to access this deposit. So you're here because you want God to give you a new supernatural deposit to be able to pray healing, right? That's why we're all here. All right, I want you to begin to think about situations you know about. We've seen a bunch of them this morning where healing needs to come. Okay? When I count to three, you're going to raise your hands and you are going to intercede for that situation or those situations at the top of your lungs. If you've prayed for one as long as you can, go to the next one. And I am telling you, as we do this corporately, the power of God and the deposit of God is going to begin to fall in our midst. And there is something that's going to break. There is something that's going to break. Is your faith ready? I'm going to count to three. One, two, three. Come on, at the top of your lungs, intercede, call out, cry out, cry out, cry out. Ask him to intercede. Warriors against infirmity. Holy Spirit, we ask that you fall on us today and that we would be able to pray with great power and healing would come, that we would be able to change situations and that healing would come. God, give us the anointing of healers in our prayer life. Give us the anointing of healers in our prayer life. Make us prayers of healing. Come, Holy Spirit, deposit yourself in our midst. Something supernatural and outside of ourselves. Come, Holy Spirit, give us what we lack. Give us what we lack. We cry out to you today. Do a new thing in this church. Do a new thing in us individually. Come, Holy Spirit. Come with your power. Give us supernatural power in prayer to see healings and miracles and signs and wonders. Come, God. Give us your deposit.
Worship the Lord. You need to worship the Lord. Worship is warfare. Worship God. God is good. Worship the Lord. Worship Him. Worship Him. Worship Him. Worship Him. Until He gives us breakthrough, worship the Lord, worship Him. Yes.
know you might not all been in Sunday school this morning, but this morning Chris Powell spoke out of the book of 2 Chronicles with Jehoshaphat and the war that they were to go into. And in the midst of that war, what they were to do was to let the worshipers go before him. And it is right. So what I just want to just bring that up to say, hey, wait a minute. What are we doing this morning? Well, we're doing the Bible. We're doing the Bible. This is biblical. This is the Bible. And I feel like we really do. There's some things, there's a couple of other things I want to do this morning. While we're doing, can we just lift up our voices? Let's sing this song. Let's let the worship of God arise.
Everything I have means nothing. Jesus, if you're not my one thing, everything I need right now. If you're not my one thing, everything I need right now, and all I know is everything I have means nothing, Lord. Everything I need right now, and all I want is everything you want.
Because he wants to have life and life abundantly. And I think more importantly, he wants us to remind us over and over and over again who's God and who's not God, that he's God and we're not, that he's in charge and all those things. But in the midst of that, God can heal our bodies and we can lose our souls. And so this morning, before we completely changed gears, when Christ went to the cross, he went to the cross for the stripes to heal us physically, but he most importantly went to the cross to redeem us of our sins. And in the book of Corinthians, it says, let those that come into the house see the work of the Spirit of God so that they might come and know him as God. And so this morning, before we completely shift gears, if there's anyone in here this morning by under the sound of my voice that does not know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, that you are not right now walking in a relationship, a person-to-person real relationship with Jesus, there's no better day than today to come to know the Lord Jesus Christ. And if you're in this room and do not know Jesus, if you just want to come through the crowd and come up front here, I want to pray for you. Anybody here that doesn't know Jesus, that wants to get their life right with God today, and you maybe you know Jesus and you want to get your life right with God today, it's a good day to get your life right with God. Maybe there's other stuff going on. If you're in that place, come forward. I'm going to pray for Cody. He's raising his hand here. I'm going to pray for Cody. But if you're here and there's anything going on, you're not in the place. Let me just say it this way. You're not in the place where you know God wants you to be in your relationship with him. Let's pray for you. And in the midst of that, if you're listening to my voice and and your heart's beating from the inside out, and you go, I really don't know if I know who this Jesus is. Come on up, we'll teach you, we'll show you, we'll tell you. And Jesus wants to make himself whole in your life. Shalom, come on up if you want to come up, Jesus. Go ahead and worship. Come, Lord God.
For you. the demons run and flee at the mention of your name. You're the King of Majesty.
Of the Lord will fill this place, and His presence will be in your life. He leads me to 2 Chronicles 7:14. When we humble ourselves before Him, He will heal our lands. He will forgive our sins. He will give restoration to everything in our life. The meaning of the glory of God to come in this land and to this house is not a specific piece of land, but it is speaking about you and me today. His presence will be a real fact in your life. So please, before Pastor asks the children to come, let's pray again. Ask Him to come back to your life. I humble myself before you, God, today. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Your presence is here. You are ready to come. He's ready to come to you today. Accept Him. Receive Him. The glory of the Lord will fill this place. The presence of God will cover your life from now on. Ask you for all those who have baptized with the Holy Spirit. Speak in tongues now. Release the Holy Spirit in this place now, please. Accept and receive a new power from the Holy Spirit.
That verse has come up that you spoke about several times here recently. My people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray. Will humble themselves and pray. If my people will humble themselves and pray, then I will come and I'll heal their land. That isn't just a verse for what was going on then. It's a verse for now. It's a verse for today. If we as a people of God will call upon the name of the Lord and humble ourselves and pray, He will come and do a great work in us. Do a great work in our lives. Got a couple more things. Hold on a minute.
Yeah.
leader come forward, please? Every school-age person. I know we've got one. I know we've got one more, another week yet before school actually officially starts, but we're getting real close. Come on in. There's been some good things that's happened amongst you guys this summer, a work that God's been wanting to do. But God's not done, and we're just getting ready to start a school year. And God wants to keep doing it. I think, Abby, you had a... gone to a conference this summer, and then during that time God really spoke in the midst of our youth group leaders and about a real healing that needs to take place in your hearts and your lives, and a work that needs to happen where he restores relationships and restores strength in the midst of it and does a deep work in your lives. And that's a process, and that's not a one-time thing, that's a whole time thing. And Shabaka, could you come here and you pray? I feel like you're supposed to pray for our kids, and we may do this again, but today it just is the right day to pray.
Father, we say for the lives of these young people. And Lord, right now we just pray for them, God, that your spirit would be among them. Father, that your Holy Spirit would live inside of them. Father, we commit them into your hands right now, Lord. I know that many of them have been dedicated by their parents already, but Lord, we come and in your presence today, we rededicate them to the purposes of God. Father, we ask that you would bless them in every way, God, that you desire to bless them. Father, we ask that there would be an outpour of wisdom and of understanding, God, that they would begin to grow and to develop in ways that bring you honor and that glorify your name. Father, every assignment of hell that has been set against their lives, God, we stand against it right now in the name of Jesus. God, we curse the plans and the schemes of the enemy, and we release right now the will of God, the will of heaven, the purpose of God over each and every one of their lives. Father, we ask now for revival that is deep, that is lasting, that is pure, that is true, that is real, that is ongoing. Father, we ask right now that the voice of the Lord would be released in their ears, God, that they would begin to hear conviction, not just from the mouth of parents, not just from the mouth of preachers or leaders or teachers, but God, that the very voice of the Spirit of God would speak inside of them, and that they would be changed. Father, we ask right now, Lord, that everything that the enemy has meant for evil, that you would turn it now for good. Lord, we ask that there will be wholeness and help in their relationship. God, that as teenagers, Lord, that they would not be stupid. God, we pray against stupidity right now in the name of Jesus. We pray against foolishness right now in the name of Jesus. And God, we thank you that there is grace to make mistakes and that there is abundant grace to repent and to get it right when we've done it wrong. Father, we pray now for a preservation of purity over each and every one of their lives. God, what the devil would try to come and steal and rob from them, God, we stand right now in the gap and we fight for them to be pure. We fight for them to be righteous. God, we fight that they would be preserved by your presence and your spirit in the name of Jesus. And Father, I even pray, Lord, as a teacher and a principal in their lives, God, I pray that there would be great academic success in this next school year. God, that it would be their portion, God, those that have struggled, that they would struggle no more. God, those that have had difficulty and challenges, that they would be challenged no more in that way. God, those that have been lazy, God, I pray for supernatural, godly motivation, Lord, to rest upon their shoulders. Come on, young people, if you know him and love him, would you just lift your hands to him right now? I just feel like we need to ask him for a baptism of grace. Just ask him in your own words, God, give me the grace for all that I need. God, grace to love you in the midst of my peer group. God, grace to walk upright.
got grace to handle that crush. Come on, there's grace, young people. Grace. Grace, grace, grace. Got grace to deal with peer pressure. Got grace with trauma and turmoil in my home. Got grace when I don't know what to do. Got grace when I do know what to do but want to go the wrong way. God, we ask now for a baptism of grace, God. You would cover us. You would be with us.
Thank you. You guys can go back. God is good. If you're fairly new to being here as a part of us, or if you're a visitor today, let me say a few things before we're dismissed. We absolutely, positively, the best we can, you can go and have a seat. We love the Word of God, and we want to love it even His Word even more. Matter of fact, I was going to talk about this morning about responding to His voice and about His Word. But there really is times when in the midst of knowing Him and in the midst of doing, in the midst of believing fully in what this says, part of believing fully is doing something about it. And so we want to teach it, we want to preach it, we hold it very highly, the preached word. I feel like you can't get anything past this. At the same time, there are times and there are seasons and there are moments in the Spirit of God when it's just right to let the Word do its work. And God is a healer, and we're going to believe Him for that. God is restorer and redeemer. He saves us, and He saves sinners, and we're going to believe that and trust that and open the door for that. We that God comes and loves us dearly and loves us personally enough to want to restore the deep recesses of our hearts and our souls, and we want to give room for that. We also, I truly, absolutely believe that God's wanting to do a deep work in our house and in this place. And that we would let the Word of God be the Word of God and let it come forth with great boldness and let it have great action in this house, in this room, when we gather as a people for a meeting. But even more importantly, as we walk down the road, as we get up in the morning and go to bed at night, as we sit down to read it, as we talk about it, as we eat it, that it would produce great work in the midst of us. And even where the enemy wants to come steal, kill, and destroy, because he's been, let me just tell you, the devil's been on overtime this week. The you know, Pastor Charlie used to talk about the stupid bug. It bit this week. But God's a redeemer. God's restorer. God's the one who can make things whole and well, and we're going to believe and trust that to happen. Because I do believe that if us as His people will humble ourselves, repent, trust God, turn ourselves over to Him, fall down in His mercy, surrender, and we will pray, He will come and heal us. He will come and show us. He will come and restore us. He will come and take us into the day He wants us to move into. And that's for sure what needs to happen. Dave Richter, where he was, said, you know, you can't pour old wine into new wine into old wineskins. And God really does have to come and do a repent. We have to do continually work repentance in us so our wineskins are continually new, so we can continually pour out some new wine. And that's where I believe God has had us this morning, today. I love you guys. I appreciate this church and being a part of it. Love to see all your faces. Love to see the new ones, new people that are here. It's exciting to see that. But can we keep praying for these things? You know, it's like, it's not just we pray and we're done. God really wants to do a deep, deep, deep work in our lives. And whether it's healing, whether it's restoration, whether it's salvation, whatever it is, that He does the work. And school's going to get ready to start right back up again, and we really need God to move in the midst of our children.
and that it happens again and again and again and again and again and again and again over and over. So if you don't, one more time, if you would stand, I'll pray and we'll be dismissed. God, we thank you. Lord, today we praise you. We exalt you. We lift your name on high. We lift the name of Jesus, the name above all names, the name that heals, the name that restores, the name that has great power to do great work in our lives and all around the world. Lord, we just pray for your presence to be with us all day. We pray, God, as even as we come back tonight, that you'd anoint Tom to bring the word, and you do a work in us again. Lord, transform us, change us. But Lord, we pray that you are God among us, that we are your people, Lord, that we would cry out in your name. And Lord, we thank you that you're personal, God, that you're God that does come, and you're a God that does reveal, and you're a God that does speak and allows us to hear. And we thank you for your blessing. We thank you for your presence. We thank you for your power. We thank you for grace. We thank you for mercy. In Jesus' name.